Norman Lear is a TV icon like none other. Even if, for some reason, you've never heard of the guy, you've certainly heard of his work. He helped create some of the most influential sitcoms of all time. All in the Family, One Day at a Time, Maude, Sanford and Son, the list goes on and on. Another show that Lear created, The Jeffersons, gave us one of the catchiest theme songs in TV history. Lear also produced the beloved 1987 fantasy film The Princess Bride, which was directed by his good friend and fellow legend Rob Reiner. Lear also had his hands in the production of films like Fried Green Tomatoes and Way Past Cool. But seriously, check out his credits on IMDB. Calling his contributions extensive is an understatement. This guy doesn't stop working, and it seems like everything he touches, with rare exceptions, turns to gold. Even now, at 98, he's still going strong, but we'll catch up with what he's been up to recently in just a minute. This is the untold and somewhat shocking story of Norman Lear, one of television's most prolific visionaries. He holds an Emmy record. You might be wondering how Lear managed to get to the top of the Hollywood ladder. Well, it's not the easiest question to answer, but one thing we're sure of is it wasn't because of his family connections. His dad worked as a securities broker and ended up going to jail for selling fake bonds when Norman was just a boy. Lear was born in New Haven, Connecticut in 1922. He served in World War II as a gunner and radio operator before finding his way to New York City in 1945. There, he worked as a publicist for a measly $40 a week. But this wasn't what he really wanted to be doing with his life. So in 1949, he packed his bags and moved to California to look for work as a comedy writer. He wasn't about to live his life slaving away for a meager wage without chasing his dreams. He knew that we all have just one life to live, so he was determined to make it count. In 1950, he was hired on as a writer for the comedy variety program Ford Star Review with Jack Haley. Shortly thereafter, he scored another gig writing for the comedy anthology series The Colgate Comedy Hour. Norman Lear's career has been nothing short of awe-inspiring. After he made it, he never stopped working. It's been his relentless tenacity that has helped establish himself as one of the most influential names in American TV history. In 2019, at 97, he became the oldest person to be nominated for and to win an Emmy Award for the category of Outstanding Variety Special for live in front of a studio audience, Norman Lear's All in the Family and The Jeffersons. Lear then broke his own record at age 98 when he won the same award for live in front of studio audience, All in the Family and Good Times. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, make sure you give it a like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Tap the bell icon to turn on notifications. And keep watching to find out how Lynn Lear, Norman's wife, has been one of the most inspiring figures in his life. Norman Lear's book and podcast. His talents aren't limited exclusively to the realms of TV and movies. He's also written a memoir titled Even This I Get to Experience, which was published by Penguin Books in 2014. The title of the book comes from a chapter in his life where he fell on some financially troubling times, despite the fact he had experienced substantial success career-wise. At one point, he thought he might even have to sell his home. Having heard he had fallen on hard times, his son-in-law called him up and asked how he was feeling. Lear wrote, "My answer was terrible, of course. But I must be crazy because despite all that's happened, I keep hearing this inner voice saying, even this I get to experience." In 2017, Lear launched his podcast, All of the Above with Norman Lear, which has hosted guests like Amy Poehler, Julia Louis-Dreyfus, and Antonio Banderas. He's one selfish cat. Norman Lear has been married 3 times. He married his first wife, Charlotte Rosen, in 1943. They welcomed one child into the world, a daughter named Ellen. Both Ellen and Charlotte were by Norman's side when he made that fateful move from New York to California in 1949 to pursue his dream of writing comedy. Lear married his second wife, Frances Loeb, in 1956, and they ended up having 2 daughters together, Maggie and Kate. After 29 years of marriage, the couple divorced in 1985. Frances Loeb made headlines for her eye-watering $100 million settlement, which, according to the Chicago Tribune, was one of the largest settlements at the time. But even after taking such a huge loss, Lear's net worth today is still estimated to be upwards of $200 million. Lear married his third wife, Lynn Davis, in 1987. They ended up having 3 children together, Brianna, Benjamin, and Madeline. As of 2021, they're still happily married after more than 30 years of matrimony. Lynn has called Lear one of the last of the real romantics. She's also shared that even after all these years, they still start off their mornings with a kiss as soon as they wake up. Lear is equally full of praise for his wife. When recently asked what he thinks about his other half, he gloated, "I love the way she loves me. I'm just one selfish cat." Lynn Lear, a woman of many hats. Like her husband, Lynn is an accomplished filmmaker and activist. She's produced a myriad of poignant documentaries on such topics as climate change, investigative journalism, and modern developments in technology and medicine. Her 2019 film, The Great Hack, which explored social media's role in the 2016 election, was nominated for an Emmy. Lear also sits on the board of directors of numerous organizations that she strongly believes in, such as the LA County Museum of Art, the Norman Lear Center, and the National Academy of Medicine's Healthy Longevity Advisory Council. She has a PhD in clinical psychology and a license in family and marriage therapy. Despite the fact that Lynn and Norman have both enjoyed wildly successful careers complete with hectic schedules, their marriage appears to have been fortified by their family-first philosophy. Norman told Business Insider he thinks he and his wife have done a really good job, but pointed out that having a happy and healthy family life requires constant care and maintenance. Norman's political opinions have made him some enemies. Norman Lear has always been unapologetically opinionated. It's fairly clear he cares deeply about the world he lives in. And even though his work has primarily focused around Hollywood, his political views have earned him his fair share of enemies. In 1980, after watching all of Reverend Jerry Falwell's old-time gospel hour, Lear decided to abruptly stop filming the movie he was working on and quickly produced a 60-second commercial on religious intolerance instead. This chapter led to Lear forming the People for the American Way in 1981 with the help of Congresswoman Barbara Jordan. The purpose of the group was to reduce national division by increasing communication among different and opposing groups throughout society. Lear advocated for secularism and firmly believed that religion had no place in politics. Jerry Falwell responded to Lear's action by declaring him an enemy of the American family. Falwell accused him of being anti-Christian and harboring a vendetta against those who preached the gospel. Lear didn't let such baseless accusations get to him, however. As a practicing Jew, he knew no one that really knew him could ever call him anti-religious. In a scathing reply to Falwell's unsubstantiated claims, he called the televangelist out for what he perceived as blatant anti-Semitism. Lear does whatever he pleases. It should come as no surprise that Norman Lear has always lived his life as freely as circumstances have allowed. Over the years, he's developed a wide array of interests. He's actually close friends with South Park's co-creator, Trey Parker. He even officiated his wedding. Lear lent his own voice to South Park in 2003 when he voiced Benjamin Franklin in the episode I'm a Little Bit Country. He's also known for his outspoken views towards different U.S. presidents. In 1999, he was awarded the Presidential Medal of Arts by then-President Bill Clinton. But in 2017, he refused to attend the White House reception for the Kennedy Center honorees in protest of President Trump, who he accused of deliberately neglecting the arts and humanities by deliberately defunding them. He was also critical of President George W. Bush. Specifically, he was opposed to Bush's Iraq War. The only non-Democrat he voted for was John Anderson in 1980 because he considered the Carter administration incompetent. Now it's time to hear from you. Are you a fan of All in the Family, or were the Jeffersons more your cup of tea? Let us know in the comments section below. And before you go, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.